Grace and peace. And praise the Lord. The piece I'll be sharing with you on today is entitled Dr. King's Speech. A dream of a world where all of us will come together hand in hand in unity, walking across the land in peace, love, and embracing one another. Embracing unity and never being judgmental towards one to another. For the Bible tells us in Matthew 7:1, judge not, lest ye be judged. A dream where every person will look for the good within towards each and every one. One man's dream not long ago was to make the wrong things right, and in the future, a guaranteed better victorious life. For free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last. Thank you.
Dr. King stared for love and peace.
One of Martin Luther King's quotes says, I have decided to stick with love. Hate is too big a burden to bear. And I feel like that goes along with a lot of the things that is going on right now. All the events, the police brutality, the rallies, the protests. It's just some people feel like they're feeling hatred, but I feel like love is stronger than hate. And you should love your neighbors as yourself. That's what the Bible says.
That I chose from Martin Luther King is, the time is always right to do what is right. And I chose this quote because it kind of shows like he did this in his life, even though other people, there was injustice during that time, and he still stood up when not a lot of people might have agreed with him, and he was going through a hard time. He still stood up for what he believed in, and this helps me to realize that I need to do the same and help other people around me to do the same, to stand up for what's right in protest and different things that are happening.
Dr. King showed people what to love.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s inspiration and impact on my life definitely came from his speeches and the marches. It inspired me to become a better public speaker and to be a better effective communicator all in all, and learn how to actually reach and motivate people. It also inspired me to take action towards injustice and stand up to it and fight for your equal rights and fight for what matters for you.
What would you do if you were one of 600 people, a part of a peaceful protest that would soon become one of the most chilling moments in American history? Sunday, March 7th, 1965 was the day when civil rights activists including Dr. Martin Luther King, John Lewis, Hosea Williams, and many others set out to walk from Selma to the capital of Montgomery, both for freedom and in honor of a young man who was fatally killed by a troop member for protesting. They had walked from Selma and were approaching Montgomery when they had came to a halt a few feet away from where a line of police were standing to stop them. When told to return home or go to the church, protesters refused and continued to stand where they stopped and were brutally attacked by police. If it weren't for these brave souls who stood up for their rights and wanted to give us a better future, no change would have been made and we would still be fighting today. So for that, we say thank you.
Let me Luther King had an impact on numerous things. He had a vision that changed the future. He advocated for voting rights for African Americans through his ballot speech in 1957. It affected me by showing me the history and importance of voting rights and why they are essential. His speech is just as relevant as it was in 1957. Martin Luther King's fight for voting rights helped us to progress to where we are today.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
My name is Joshua Mitchell, and I would like to honor and remember Dr. Martin Luther King by the I Have a Dream speech, in which he says, "You should not judge a person by the content of their skin color, but the content of their attitude."
A Martin Luther quote that affected me was when he said, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent on things that matter." That really affected me, especially now, because there's a lot of people that normalize everything happening, like the protests, the attacks on Capitol. And this like helped me reflect on my life to say, you know, like, this is not normal and how we should not be silent about things that are important, especially now.